Hi everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Michelle Hyers and I teach the fashion and interior design classes at Eastern High School. Welcome to our 10th annual fashion show. Things clearly look a little bit different this year, but we're still celebrating the amazing work of the fashion students. Many of these students have voluntarily signed up for the class 2, 3, or 4 years. And I have such an honor of working with them this year, especially given the circumstances. But these students have really risen above. They've gone above and beyond, and their resiliency is amazing. They managed to turn every negative into a positive, and I couldn't be more proud of them. So I hope you enjoy the show, and it's our chance to celebrate these wonderful ladies. So thank you so much for watching. Welcome to our 10th annual Eastern Camden County Regional High School Fashion Show. Every year we strive to highlight the creativity of Eastern's design students. Coco Chanel once said, "Fashion has to do with ideas, the way we live, and what is happening." Each new year brings new challenges, and this year has been no exception. But I believe how we embrace these challenges is what makes us more creative, resilient, and adaptable. This year's Expression 2 class has taught me how to become more innovative, overcome obstacles, and persevere in the face of adversity. Nothing could have prepared me for the 2020-2021 school year. My teaching philosophy has always focused on learn by doing and collaboration. Starting this year from my daughter's bedroom quickly made me realize that what I loved most about teaching seemed impossible to achieve. There would be no fashion show, no field trips, no classroom full of sewing machines, and no chatty teenagers. Instead, I saw a bunch of black rectangles with names on Zoom. Oscar de la Renta said, "The great thing about fashion is that it always looks forward." So that's what we did. We moved forward and created something special. The 13 young ladies that make up my Expression 2 class are some of the most impressive and inspiring young women I have had the privilege of working with so far. In a world of chaos and confusion this year, my advanced fashion students helped fabricate something resembling normalcy. Since the first day of school, these 13 ladies have hit the ground running. Their homes were transformed into fashion studios and their bedroom sewing stations. There were no limitations to their creativity, ambition, and enthusiasm. This year, they embraced the opportunity to create our theme for the fashion show, Female Style Icons. As the Expression 2 class shared their ideas about what inspired them, they were inspiring me. These young women all possess qualities I hope to instill in my daughter. Each designer had the task of selecting a style icon that would be the inspiration for their collection. With experience in clothing construction, an eye for design, and technological advances, each student created garments both physically and virtually to display their work. I'm incredibly proud to share with you the work of my Expression 2 students.
A man is not a necessity, a man is a luxury, like dessert.
Yeah. A man is absolutely not a necessity.
Did you mean that to sound mean and bitter?
Oh, not at all. I adore dessert. I love men. I think men are the coolest. But you don't really need them to live. My mom said to me, "You know, sweetheart, one day you should settle down and marry a rich man." And I said, "Mom, I am a rich man."
Thank you.
went from a low to a lot this year. Everybody mad at the rocks that I wear. I know where I'm going and I know where I'm from. You hear locks in the air.
Yeah, we at the airport out. D-block from the block where everybody air forced out.
With a new white tee, you fresh. Nothing phony with us. Make the money, get the man, bring it on these with us.
I'm still Jenny from the block. Used to have a little, now I have a lot. No matter where I go, I know where I came from. Don't be fooled by the locks that I got. I'm still Jenny from the block. Used to have a little, now I have a lot.
Tonight she's being honored as the Radio Disney chart topper.
Please put your hands together for Ariana Grande!
I'm inspired by Ariana Grande because I've always loved who she is throughout her years. I've watched her on television ever since she was on Victorious. She's a very inspiring woman and she's not afraid to speak her mind. Something I like most about her is that she doesn't care what other people think about her. She's also a good role model because of her good work ethic, successfulness, and her ability to use her platform for good. She's been working ever since she was 15 years old, and I hope one day to have such a great work ethic like she does. Given the challenges of COVID, I wanted to design and make the outfits that I weren't able to make, so here are some of them.
Come on. parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour, des mots de tous les jours, et ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur, une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause.
Take it. No, you wanna see me naked, naked, naked. I wanna be a baby, baby, baby. Spinning in his red just like he came from Maytag. Rock a wristed on the brown. When I get like this, I can't be around.
I chose Rihanna because she's the perfect example of a woman who is not afraid to be creative and set trends. Her style is constantly changing and inspiring people, whether it is on the red carpet or streetwear. Not only is she a fashion icon, but she's extremely inspirational and is trying to incorporate different women into the fashion industry. In her clothing and makeup line, Fenty, she uses models of every shape and color. She embraces women with unique features and inspires them to feel comfortable in what they are wearing. Due to COVID, I was unable to make some of the pieces I intended on making, but during a normal year, these upcoming outfits would be my inspiration for my project.
I wasn't looking for nobody when you looked my way. Possible candidate, yeah. Who knew that you'd be up in here looking like you do? You make us staying over here impossible. Baby, I'ma say your aura is incredible. If you don't have to go, don't. Do you know what just started? I just came here to party, but now we're rocking on the dance floor.
Hi, I would like to introduce my daughter, Taylor Clark. She has creative vision, and when she puts her mind to something, she will come out on top. I'm most proud of her never give up attitude. She made her prom dress this year, and it came out as beautifully as she is. Since I've been working crazy hours, I've had some of her models send me pictures with a message for her. Dad and I love you very much, and we look forward to seeing your video. Good luck. Congratulations. We love you.
Hey, Taylor. It's Miss Perini. I know you thought after a year of history and semester of so, she'd be done with me. But no, I'm still here. I just wanted to tell you congratulations and good luck on your show. I will see you soon.
Hi, I'm Melissa.
I'm Jen, and we're Lindsay's older sisters. We just wanted to say how proud we are of you, Lindsay. You put your all into everything you do, and you make us so proud every day.
You're so artistic, and you're just perfect at everything you do.
You're so talented, and we've loved watching you grow up and bring your artwork to life.
Our best memory that we have of you is watching you sew with our grandmother's very old sewing machine at our dining room table for the past 2 years, creating all of your dresses that you've made for fashion.
We love you so much, and we're going to miss you next year when you go to college.
Bye. We love you.
Hey, Lindsay. We just want to come here and say that you're so talented, you're an amazing friend, and we know you're going to go off to do amazing things in your career.
We are always in awe of your talents as both an artist and a fashionista, and we just wanted to say good luck at Temple.
Go Owls.
Hi, Lindsay. What's up? I want to congratulate you on all your accomplishments this year. I feel like you're one of the most smartest people I know. You're super talented. Really, you're a great friend. Really artistic. Like, every time I see your art, it amazes me, okay? And, you know, you just deserve all the praise you get. And I can't wait to see what you do in college, all right? Because if this is what you're doing in high school, like, geez, you leave some room for the rest of us, all right? Congrats again, Lindsay. Bye.
Lindsay. Where do I even begin? You're simply the most talented and artistic girl that I know. Not only have you worked and spent an insane amount of hours over the past 4 years, from art projects to fashion projects to projects for your small artistic business, your work that you have made and that I've seen you create and go from making little shoes in eighth grade to the monstrosities and dresses and crazy canvas artwork that you make now is unreal. I'm so proud of you, and you're in the next 4 years, there's so much more to come. And if you've already grown so much in 4 years, what can four more do? I'm so proud of you, Lindsay.
Hoffman, congratulations on your last and final fashion show. I cannot believe it's already here. Congratulations on everything that you have accomplished over these last 4 years. You have been absolutely amazing, and you know that Ms. Hires and I are your biggest fans. You already know this because we tell you all the time. But best of luck next year at Temple. I'm so excited for you and all you will continue to accomplish, and we will miss you so much.
I can't believe
believe we got invited to such a big premiere.
I know. Now the big question is, what are we gonna wear? Let's take a look. Where's that coming from?
My inspiration sparks from Zendaya's extreme confidence in each and every one of her looks. She always stays true to herself and embraces her sophisticated and elegant style. I am truly inspired by her mature ensembles that turn heads at the Emmy Awards, People's Choice Awards, MTV Awards, and more. Zendaya's red carpet style is simple yet gorgeous. She inspires me to create ensembles that are classy, beautiful, and timeless. As a fashion icon, Zendaya sets the standards for style extremely high, and I aspire to create garments just as iconic and influential as her magnificent red carpet looks.
Caviar dreams, you deserve nothing but all the finer things. Now this whole world has no clue what to do with us. I got enough money in the bank for the two of us. I gotta keep enough lettuce to...
Hello, we are here to introduce our wonderful daughter, Zoe Madison Holmes. She has always been our, what would you say?
Fashionista.
Absolutely. I used to have a nickname for her, Punky Brewster, even though she wasn't very familiar with the show. We knew what we were talking about, which she was very unique with her clothing line, I'd say, from literally when?
Diapers.
Yeah. She loved socks. She loved tutus. I mean, just put together very unique, her own little unique line, even when she was just in elementary school. So it comes as no surprise that when she got to high school, literally her freshman year, she couldn't wait to take fashion and to sew such wonderful creations and things that we were just like in awe about when we would come to the shows. And we just want to say, Zoe, we are so proud of you. And we know that you have, oh my gosh, a wonderful future ahead of you. Continue to be creative.
Continue to be our fashionista. Future holds for you and your creativity and your artistry. So now presenting the new line from Zoe Madison Holmes. Thank you.
We also send out a special thanks to Mrs. Hires, not only for being a wonderful teacher, but also for encouraging our baby girl to embrace her creativity.
Hi, Zoe. I just wanted to say thank you so much for being my best friend all throughout high school in these last 4 years. You've always been there for me. You've done so much for me, and I am so appreciative of you and everything that you do. I love all of our memories that we have together, like all of our beach trips, going to the zoo, going to the mall and out to eat and everything, and just like hanging out in our pajamas watching Friends. I love you so much, and I wish you the best of luck in California.
Hey Zoe, this is Mr. McSweeney. Just wanted to congratulate you on your achievement. Obviously, you know, it's been 4 years now, okay? And, you know, you always stood out as one of the students that, you know, I looked at as kind of a student leader from, you know, your role in my class freshman year, honors history, to just kind of hanging out when you and Blake and Mel used to come in for lunch. And also playing an integral role really kind of as the voice of Eastern. I mean, you probably sang at 500 athletic and academic events, the Star Spangled Banner. But obviously, you know, I just wanted to congratulate you. I know that Miss Hires has been kind of collecting, you know, different, I guess, contributions from different students and also from different teachers, kind of put together a little collage for each of you. But obviously, you know, before you leave here, we all just wanted to let you know how special you are to all of us and also to the Eastern community, okay? Good luck in everything in the future. Not that you need it, because you're smart and, you know, you're personable, so you'll do just fine, okay? But good luck with everything. Thanks, Zoe. Bye.
I feel inspired by Beyonce because I've always looked up to her ever since I could remember. She is such a strong, independent Black woman, and I've always loved how she used her platform to encourage other women. With the talent of a triple threat, meaning she can sing, act, and dance, she's a woman working in an industry that would normally be disrupted by men. With being a working woman, she is also a wife and a mother of 3 children. She inspires me every day to strive to her level of success.
Hello, my name is Effie. My daughter is Angelina Roustis. Angelina has been taking fashion since freshman year. It has served as her creative outlet in an otherwise academically challenging schedule. It has been her favorite class and she looks forward to it every day, except when Ms. Hires was on maternity leave. I was not surprised when she picked Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis as her fashion icon. She embodies so many of the qualities that Angelina had at a young age: beauty, intelligence, taste, and class. Angelina was always an old soul and wise beyond her years, and she expressed this through her fashion. And just like her, her looks have a modern, sassy twist. Her passion for everything she does is inspiring her. Watching her grow into an amazing young woman has been one of the greatest pleasures of my life. I cannot even begin to explain all the reasons that I am proud of her. Her creativity, enthusiasm, and focus to perfection is a sight to behold. She worked on a slip for hours. Standing on the museum steps, having people tell me how beautiful I looked in the gown that she made me is one of the favorite moments of my life. I am and continue to be your biggest fan and cheerleader. We watch in amazement at the inspiring and driven young woman you are. Keep developing your passions and igniting your dreams. Set the world on fire. We love you always and are so very proud of you. Alexis.
Hi everyone, I'm Alexis. I'm Angelina's cousin. One of the many things we have in common is our love for fashion. When I was in high school, I also took fashion. Hi, Ms. Hires. And since I graduated, Angelina has made it a point to include me in the fashion show every single year, and I've loved every minute of it. I'm about to be in her fashion shows and sit in the audience and see all of her amazing work come to life. I'm so excited to see your next collection, inspired by Jackie O, a fashion icon, come to life. I love you, and I'm so proud of you.
Hi Angelina, it's Shelby. I wanted to say congratulations on the past 4 most incredible years in fashion. Everything that I've seen photos of, seen in person, tried on, modeled for you, or anything has been absolutely incredible. Nothing less than 100,000% you put your effort into, and it is just amazing to watch you, and it is amazing to see how much of a hard worker and dedication and everything you put into all of your work. And I'm so honored to be one of your best friends to watch this all. And I'm so beyond thankful, even more importantly, for our friendship and everything that we've been through throughout the past like 13 years. It's crazy. And there's so many more years to come. And I can't even remember a time that has been bad or anything. All of our memories are incredible. And our moms can thank us for their amazing friendship, because where would they be without us, of course. And there's just no other words besides thankful that I could say for our friendship. You've been there for me through everything, and I will always be there for you no matter what. And I just love all of our memories and our laughs and all of our trips and everything. And hopefully we can continue to do everything in the future together. And you've been my person for so long, and I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm so honored to have had gotten the opportunity to watch you become an incredible person and so loving inside and out, and I'm so thankful for it all, and I love you so much, and I cannot wait for the rest of our memories and everything we have in store for the future years. So congratulations on an incredible 4 years in fashion. You amaze me every day, and I love you beyond words. Bye.
Hi, Ange. Mr. Mack here. I just want to take a moment to let you know how proud we all are of you here at Eastern. Simply put, Ange, I wish all students were like you. This video is a testament to the impact that you've had on the school community, especially us teachers. I want to thank you for always bringing lively discourse to my class, Modern American Issues. And I actually wanted to quote something that you said for your very last assignment for class. You were writing about the politics of fashion of the last inauguration, and you said this, quote, "I find the fashion significant because it's just one more tool that women can use to push forward their beliefs and ideas. While some may find it misogynistic to unpack and focus too heavily on their fashion, I think that this event is a great example of the women taking that message. And if people are going to talk about it, and what they're wearing, and let's be honest, they will, these women are giving them something to talk about that invokes conversations of politics, unity, of history, and peace. Ange, keep giving them something to talk about. Congratulations and good luck."
Tonight seems to be at long last the beginning of what for so long has really been just a hope or a dream.
As soon as I heard of our theme of fashion icons, my mind immediately went to the classics like Audrey Hepburn, Marilyn Monroe, Coco Chanel, and of course, Jackie Kennedy Onassis. All of these women had style that defined their time and trends that still have influence over fashion today. I picked Jackie O because I think her style and her role is most interesting for me to base a collection off of. I love that she had a prominent role in politics while still dressing with so much style and class. She was known for dignity and grace and regarded as the ideal woman while serving in the White House. I created this collection using her as an inspiration along with modern trends to give a current edge to her style.
On a sunshine, on a cloudy day. Hi, I'm introducing my daughter, Madison Scott. Madison, I just want to let you know how proud we are with your accomplishments over this last year with remote learning and the struggles of not being in the classroom. You've proved that you can overcome anything. Best of luck in your future at Stockton, and we love you and are so proud of you. Congratulations.
Hey, so Maddie and I have been best friends since 7th grade, and although we've had our ups and downs, definitely, she's always my best friend through literally everything, and Maddie's one of the most hardworking people I know. She's so dedicated, and anything she puts her mind to, she will get done, and she will do it to the best of her ability, and she's such a sweetheart and cares to everyone around her and loves everybody with all of her heart, and I'm so excited to be spending the next 4 years with Maddie at Stockton. She's going to be my roommate. And I just love her with everything that I have. And I'm so proud of her and everything she's done. I can't wait to see what she does in the future. And I know she loves fashion, and this is a big thing for her. So I'm very proud of her and just very excited for her. I love you.
We love you.
Hey, Madison, just want to give you a shout-out. Congratulations on your accomplishments. This is your three favorite phys ed teachers here giving you some love. My memory is just thinking back to freshman basketball when you were like a crazy lunatic running around. Miss those days.
My memory was softball season, your freshman year, when I depended on you to pitch every game, and you were always, you know, you always brought it. You always were, you know, instrumental to all the other players, and you
didn't talk about it. You were about.
You didn't talk about it. You be about it.
There you go.
There you go.
We're so proud of the woman you've become. I love having you in class. You've matured, but you still have your sense of humor. And we can't wait to see what you do for the future.
All the best.
Good luck in the future. Peace.
I just think people should be who they are, be proud, be comfortable, be celebrated, be happy, feel safe. And that's what I just want to promote in my existence. That's all I care about.
Hey Sarah, just wanted to let you know that your mom and I are extremely proud of everything that you've done and who you've actually become. The person that you're growing into is an absolutely amazing young lady, and I know you're going to do phenomenal when it comes to college and pursuing your dreams. And the biggest thing you can do is just keep working like you've been working hard and enjoy the rest of everything that you have. We love you. And very proud.
Hey Sarah, just wanted to tell you how proud I am of you. You've excelled in everything you've done, so when you go to college, I'm sure it won't be any different, and I'm sure you're gonna be the next Jim Cantore.
God save the prom queen, teenage daydream, just another dressed up heartbreak. God save the prom queen, only 18. In line at the party, she's the first in line at the club, and she's got that body, always gotta flaunt it, everybody's looking up. When she walks by, you wanna be her, and your boyfriend pretends not to see her, cause she's got that fire, doesn't even try, her booty has its own zip code. All the peasants bow. Who knows what's ahead? There's a house on a hill with an indoor pool and a millionaire in her bed. And the years go by and she still dreams. She's the hottest girl in town. And the makeup's stronger, gotta wear it longer just to keep a man around. God save the prom queen, teenage daydreams, just another dress up.
A special thank you to all of the parents, guardians, and supporters of our design students, the friends, family members, and mentors who participated in our video, Alice Ryan and all of Eastern's administration that continues to support our program and students, Eastern's maintenance department for providing a safe place for us this year and always, Eastern's technology department for making virtual learning possible, and I'd especially like to thank the fashion students. Your dedication and creativity inspires me every day. I wish nothing but success for you in the future. Sincerely, Michelle Hyers.